Welcome back to another Terran R monthly update. Let's dive right in and recap key milestones from May. This month, we checked off an additional 17 component level critical design reviews. At this point in the program's maturity, many of the releases are for smaller, simpler parts such as trays, brackets, and manifolds. The race is on to get these components ready before completion of the thrust structure build. First flight production continues to ramp up. We've completed drilling the thrust structure panels, employing automation to drill thousands of holes. The team loaded the LOX dome onto the circumferential friction stir welder in preparation for the next weld, and the stage 2 transfer tube is being welded, bringing us closer to completing a second stage tank. Avionics hardware for Terran R's hub, the network and low power distribution system for the vehicle, has been released and is now being built. Meanwhile, new manufacturing infrastructure is coming online. We've inspected our first flight circumferential friction stir weld with our automated phased array ultrasonic testing PAUT inspection system, and a new automated PAUT stringer inspection station for the vertical friction stir welder is under construction. The newly installed vertical turning lathe will complete multi-axis work on domes and installation of the horizontal friction stir welder, a dedicated resource to lap weld structural stringers onto our first stage panels, is underway. With Terran R deep in build phase right now, we've brought on a new leader to help us execute and scale. We're excited to welcome Robin Petitpré as SVP of Manufacturing and Supply Chain. On the testing front, engine qualification is officially underway. The qualification article was manufactured in Long Beach and shipped to NASA Stennis, where it was then activated. The test campaign has started off strong with 11 hot fires, and we've set new relativity records for test cadence by lighting the engine 4 times in less than 10 working hours. Qualification is a key step in a rocket development program, validating that the engine can meet performance and reliability requirements for flight. We expect the qualification campaign to wrap up this summer. In Long Beach, we conducted proof testing of the COPV manifold assembly to verify structural integrity and leak tightness. On the structural test stand, the teams installed strut assemblies which will simulate engine loads during test. Valve qualification is also underway, including tests on our in-house shock stand, and we're already performing development tests for future engine block valve upgrades. We recently completed successful cure and non-destructive testing of our first development panels for the raceway covers. The composite panel, which is representative of the production covers, is now being tested to verify mechanical strength properties and quality. Our launch site at LC-16 continues to come to life. Work on the horizontal integration facility is in progress, as is the foundation for the water tower, and the east flume wall of the diverter pit is complete. May has been another busy month on the path to Terran R's first flight, but we're not just focused there. In building the first vehicle, we're laying the foundation for high volume production, scalability, and end-to-end efficiency.